Hi, I'm Laura from Scitech. Welcome to Tinker and Create. In this video series, we're going to be making animal shadow puppets. Ruff, ruff, ruff. These are fun, but I think we can do better. To start off, you're going to need to pick an animal to turn into your shadow puppet. But let's talk about shadows. So shadow puppets are normally side on, because with the shadow we have up and down and left and right, but it's very hard to get a sense of depth. Also, it's just the outline. We don't get any of the detail. So think about that as you're drawing your animal. So think about the features the audience is going to need to see to know that it's your animal. Your next step is to become a zoologist and observe your animal in motion. To do that, if you've chosen a cat or a dog, you can probably go and have a look in your backyard. But if it's a more exotic animal, you might have to look on YouTube or on a zoo live stream. And if you can't find a video of your animal moving, get a bit creative. Think about what other animals might move like your animal. So I made some observations using YouTube videos and found a couple of different ways an elephant can move. It has a flexible trunk which can curl to its mouth or overhead. It has ears and their ears flap a lot. It has a tail that swishes. It can kneel down on all of fours. It walks in a really interesting way. I hadn't thought about how four-legged animals walk before. It moves one front leg, then the other back leg, then the front leg, and then the back leg. So quite an interesting pattern. But when it runs, it moves both feet at the same time, like that. It can roll around in mud and water. It can suck up water with its trunk to either drink or to spray on its back. And it also makes chewing motions with its mouth. I also discovered that there are three types of elephant. There's the African bush elephant, the African forest elephant, and the Asian elephant. And I was really interested in their tusks. Apparently, their tusks are just really long teeth, like these teeth at the front. And both male and female African elephants have tusks. But only male Asian elephants have tusks. Did some research, and an elephant's environment, its habitat, is called the savanna in Africa. And savanna has lots of long grass and beautiful sparse trees. Think Lion King. So I've decided that I want my elephant to have a trunk that can move up and down, and I want it to be able to walk. So I have drawn my elephant nice and big, the size I want the puppet to be, and I've made sure the outline's really clear. And then I've thought about where it might need to be in sections to get those movements to happen. So for the trunk, I thought about it a bit like my finger. So the trunk needs to be able to curl up and go the other way as well. So my finger has joints there, 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 and I've done the same on the trunk of my elephant, so there'll be different sections. I've also thought about the legs, and I've started to think about what the size of the leg part might be. So now it's your turn. Design your puppet, plan out its movements, and come back to the next video when you're ready.